Welcome to this video. Now we will talk about Simomatic interfacing with MQTT via Node-RED. So in the last video, you have seen how we can interface Simomatic via OPC UA. Now we will talk about MQTT, which is personally my most favorite communication protocol because it's lightweight and you can easily interface hardware and softwares. So, and this is another update for people who are working on Simomatic. You can link any MQTT client with Simomatic. So today in this video, I'm going to use Node-RED. All right. So let's see what we're going to do in this video. I'm going to show you a small example first, and then I will tell you how it has been done. So you can see in my video, I have some equipments, and these equipments are IIoT enabled. So Simomatic has MQTT client driver inside the platform. So these devices are linked with these drivers, and you can simply turn it on and on using a topic. So in MQTT, if you know, we have a broker and we have publishers and subscribers. So we have to just publish the topics to actuate the devices. This you can do using any MQTT client. So let's see an example. At the moment on the right, you can see this is Node-RED UI dashboard. And here I have mentioned IoT fan and lamp and the status. So this IoT fan, I have some buttons. So if I click on fan on, this will trigger my fan and it will start running. And if I click fan off, it will turn it off. Besides that, we have an IoT lamp you can see here. And at the moment, its status is off. So there you can see the status as well. If I turn it on, it will turn on the lamp and it will turn off the lamp. Very easy. Now we also have a sensor here. So you can see here, this is a sensor. This is also IoT enabled. And we have a status of the sensor coming here, which is off. So what I'm going to do is I will drop an object. So here you can go to product entry. You can click on these dots and drop. And here we have an object. Now this is sensed by the sensor and you can see the sensor status is on. So at the moment you are watching just the status and control via a dashboard. What is happening on the back end is it is actually subscribing to the topics and publishing as well. So before we go back to the Node-RED backend, I want to show you another interesting example. You can see in my hand, I have this Wi-Fi switch. This is a hardware Wi-Fi switch. I can also use this switch to actuate something inside Simomatic, again via MQTT. So let's see an example. At the moment, you can see here, smart button connection is to the fan. So this is my smart button, which is like Wi-Fi smart button. It is connected to a fan. So if I click this one, it will take some time to connect to the MQTT client. So I clicked once and you will see fan is running. And if I click it again, this will stop the fan. So how the signal is passing, this Wi-Fi switch is having MQTT, is also an MQTT client. It sends a signal to the broker, and this fan is subscribing to this topic from the broker. So this is how it's working. I can also use this switch to control the lamp using this drop-down menu. So now this is linked to the lamp. So if I click it once, and in few seconds, it will send the message, and you can see the lamp is on. And now the lamp is off. So let's see what is happening all behind it. What's the logic? How these devices are talking via MQTT? Let's have a look. So I will stop the simulation and I will show the panels. So let's see the devices here on the left. We have main components, IoT components, and product entry. So I will just check one example, IoT lamp. So this is actually this lamp, which is hanging on the top. And now if you see IP address, now this is the IP address of the broker. So the broker is actually in my Node-RED. So in my Node-RED, I have defined a broker. This is my broker. And if you see the port is 183 by default, you know IoT, the MQTT port address is always 183. And security, I have nothing. So this is local port because this is in my computer. So it uses IP address of my computer. So the IP address which I mentioned here, this is the IP address of my computer. And I can confirm you using a window, which I can take command prompt. And if I type ipconfig, you will see this IP address is here. So this is the same IP address in my Simomatic IP address settings. And this is linked to my computer. You can see this is a web address. This is linked to my computer via a gateway. So you have to make sure your gateway is running all the time. This will connect your web platform with your local platform. Okay. So IP address is mentioned here. You don't have to mention port address. This is by default defined in the MQTT client 183. This is defined inside. You don't have to change it. So just mention your IP address and the topic. So the topic for this LAMP is LAMP. Simple as that. Now if I go to my Node-RED again, you can have a look. I can trigger the LAMP. So this is my LAMP, and I have this button on and off. So on button is just sending a payload, which is string, on. And off button is sending a payload off. To what? To a topic, which is LAMP. And this is the IP address of my PC and MQTT port. So I subscribe, I publish a topic LAMP with a string on and off to the broker, which is here. So I send it to the broker. Now this broker is linked to my Simomatic via this IP address. That's how this is interface. So this LAMP is getting the value from the two buttons which I'm pressing. So when I press the button on again, when I press on, it sends string on to the broker, and broker sends the value to the subscriber. So this LAMP is subscribing to the broker. That's how it's working. Off will turn it off like that. Similarly, if it's a fan, if I click fan on, it sends to the fan, because fan is connected to a socket with a topic socket. Okay, that's how fan is getting on as well. Now, how this MQTT is working inside Simomatic, this we just talked about, sending the signal or publishing the values. What is happening inside, we'll have a short look. So if I go to the LAMP and go to view, that's my view of the LAMP, and just go to editor. In editor, there are some symbols, some base link. So this is basically a symbol of my LAMP, some base link, how this looks like. Interesting is the behavior. If you click on the behavior, here you will see a small script which works behind the MQTT. Okay, before coming to the script, let me show you the communication driver. So this driver type, if you see here, is MQTT client. So this LAMP has been assigned a driver. You can also import your own 3D drawings of a LAMP, and you can assign a driver just like this one, and you have your own IIoT device. How crazy is that? So if you see the drivers, you have ABB driver, development, client, OPC UA. You can also make your own OPC UA client, S7 protocol, RoboDK driver, or UART driver. All right, so this LAMP has been assigned a driver. And now if I come back to behavior, here you have all the scripts defined. For example, if this LAMP is initialized, this is the bulb color. Maybe it's defined, it's off. Actuator state is zero, actuator value is off. Okay, so this is the initialization. When the MQTT driver is initialized, I will come back to the bottom. You will see when the driver status is running. In this case, it will check the topic. If the topic subscribe has a value on, right? In this case, the current will be equivalent to the defined current. It will have some voltage value, current value, and the bulb color will change. This is when you send on. If you send something else, then everything will goes off. The bulb color will goes to off. So you can also change the script to change. If you have a three state, you can say on 100%. Then the bulb intensity will be 100%. If you send on 50%, you can use if-else statement to change the intensity of the LAMP. So you can have analog LAMP instead of digital LAMP. All you have to do is write some scripts here, and you have your self-defined IoT device. This is what I wanted to show you, how it works. And just go ahead. You can use this environment MQTT from Simomatic library. All you have to do is go to the library, load this component, and you have this library. And then you can just play around by changing the topics from the fan of the wall switch, or you can create your own components, and then you can interface that either with Node-RED, or if you have your own MQTT client, for example, MQTT Box, you can also use that. Any MQTT client you can use. For example, let's take a short look of, I will use MQTT Box, and this is a Windows app. This can also control Simomatic environment. So it doesn't matter which MQTT client you're using. So let's say I'll connect to the local host, and I will take the LAMP and I will publish on. So when I publish on, I should check Topic to publish. Wait a second, I should check with my connections. So here I have to put glue.168.0.7.1. Okay, and save. Now publisher, publish lamp, payload on, publish. Now we can see that the lamp is on. If I send payload off, this will turn off the lamp. Similarly, you can add a topic for the fan, and for the fan, I have a topic socket, not the fan. So if I send off, it will turn off the lamp. If I send on, it will turn on the lamp. And similarly, you will also get the status in Node-RED, because in the end, you're sending the status to the broker. So fan status is on. If I turn it off from here, you will see the status will goes back to off, and also for the lamp. All right, this is how you can interface any MQTT client to Simomatic. This is the objective of this video. I hope you liked it, and try out. If you find any difficulties, you can go back to the wiki and have some resources, or you can write a comment and I would be happy to help you. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned something new, and let's see what we have in the next video. Bye.